This is my NC MX-5 or Miata, and today we're going to be doing some sound deadening in the trunk. The trunk sound deadening, it tends to be the single most bang for effort deadening mod that you can do. I mean, you can of course remove the carpet and everything in the cabin as well and do sound deadening there, but a lot of noise just gets transmitted through the trunk, and it's a big metal barrel, so it's plenty of room for sound to kind of bounce around and resonate. So first step is you want to remove all of your trunk interior trim and lining. It's just a matter of removing a bunch of plastic rivets. You just need a pry tool for that or a flathead screwdriver, and some 10 millimeter bolts to get this shielding off. There's a metal aluminium shielding piece that sits here between the fuel piping and the rest of the trunk. So you'll need to get that off as well. 10 millimeter bolts, probably one over there, one down here, and a couple of them around this section here. Really easy to find, really easy to get to. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna wipe down all of the surfaces where I'm gonna stick my sound deadening with some silicone and wax remover. It's the same sort of stuff you use before you paint something. All right, so all done, everything's clean. Next thing is we're gonna plan out our strategy. Now, sound deadening isn't something that you just wanna stick anywhere and everywhere. You wanna understand how it works so that you can use it as efficiently as possible. It's not easy to stick on just about any and every surface, like, you know, down there. Also, it adds weight and it's pretty expensive. I'm using Dynamat Xtreme. There are a bunch of other really good ones that you can use, like Noico and whatnot. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna prioritize the main areas that's gonna make the biggest difference. If I'm left with any material at the end, then I might, you know, cut it up into smaller bits and get it into some finer nooks and crannies and stuff. So the areas that you wanna focus on are gonna be large surfaces that have very little ribbing. And when I say ribbing, I'm talking about kind of these ridges and grooves that have been stamped into the sheet metal. And the reason why you wanna prioritize large surfaces with minimal ribbing, an example would be kind of here, this big flat surface here, and this section over here, because what these ridges are, what the ribbing does is it reinforces the metal. It makes the sheet metal stiffer and harder, harder to bend. And if it becomes stiffer and harder, that means that it's going to vibrate less. And if it vibrates less, then it means it's going to transfer less sound energy. I'm going to start with this big flat section in the middle. Then I'm going to take care of this big flat section over here on the right side. I'm going to make one long strip that goes along here. And then I'm going to make a big sheet that goes over here in this section over here. And then I'm also going to go along this big piece here on the interior. Now, this isn't part of the car's body. It kind of bolts in from the other side. But I'm going to put some sound deadening along there as well. And then if I'm left with any material at the end, I'm going to try and get into the inside of the rear quarter panel, just the parts that I can reach. Probably I'm gonna try and squeeze something behind these pipes and over the rear wheel well, the left wheel well, and I'm gonna try and squeeze some just along there as well. You wanna avoid covering up any bolt holes or where these trim clips go, because I wanna put all of my interior trim back in. By the way, as I was kind of showing you the inside of my trunk, you're probably wondering what these little blobs of black liquid are. That's a rust converter, because there are these kind of little chips in there, probably from, you know, dirt and debris getting underneath the carpet. I just wanted to make sure that I cover that up with something before I stick sound deadening, because I won't be able to get to that again after I do the sound deadening. So a quick progress update. First of all, I highly recommend getting some of these LED magnetic work lights. I got these dirt cheap, 10 of them in a set for about $50 delivered to my door on AliExpress, and I put a link in the description. Really handy, got both of these to light up the trunk while I'm working. Like I did say in the beginning, that you should avoid covering up any holes for bolts and clips, and I just had this complete moment of stupidity where my brain just switched off and I went ahead and stuck on these things, and I was like, oh man, what do I do now? Now, not to panic, there are two clips that hold down the carpet,
And what I did is I just took a fine drill bit and used my hand to just kind of open up a hole there and there. Because, I mean, when you push this stuff on and roll it on, you can easily kind of make out the contours and the shapes underneath it. So it's really easy to tell where those holes are supposed to be. So, yeah, just took a little drill bit and twisted it around over the mat and was able to open up a hole for the carpet clips to go in. But I know I'm going to be a lot more cautious with that for the rest of this project.
All right, and I'm done. I just ran out of deadening. I think if I had a little bit more,
I would have liked to put a little bit more along here. But like I said before, it's not so important to get these kind of corners and ridges covered, or any of the ribs, because the main areas that are going to resonate are going to be these large flat surfaces. In fact, even after I've stuck the sound deadening on, if you listen to this, it still resonates quite a bit compared to that section over there. From that, what I've learned is the one place, if you're only going to buy a tiny bit of sound deadening, let's say, you know, two foot by 1 foot sheet, you want to just stick that one sheet here and not anywhere else. And that's where you're going to get the most bang for buck. I've also put some sound deadening, just little pieces that I had at the end, kind of cut them up and spread them around other small sections. I don't think they're going to have as much of an effect in these areas here, but I thought, why not? I mean, there's some fairly flat surfaces, so I thought I might as well just stick them on there anyway, better than nothing. And I also managed to get the inside of the rear quarters as well, as you can see there. And a little bit on the top of the wheel arches as well there. I used three whole sheets to get all this coverage. By the way, that there, a little pair of cutters, really handy to have. They work a whole lot better, make the job a whole lot easier than regular scissors. You can just use regular scissors or a box cutter, but that made the job a whole lot easier. Only downside to using that, or even a pair of scissors, is you get kind of these jagged edges, and because you're working with basically aluminum foil with Butyl rubber backing, Butyl adhesive backing, these edges are pretty dangerous. You don't want to be pressing these on with your fingers, even though that's actually what I did. You can see the black paint actually came off on my fingers. You do want to be using like a roller of some sort, and for those really tricky, hard to reach areas, you can maybe use your finger or like a plastic pry tool to kind of get into those edges. But even though it's one of those do as I say, not as I do sort of things, I managed to get all of this done just with my hands. Use kind of, you know, my nails and all that for getting these contoured to fit into all of those shapes and made sure there's no air in there. But if you do have one of those rollers, and make the job a whole lot easier, so I recommend that as well. So everything you could possibly need to do something like this, I've linked in the description below, and I've put even links not just to Dynamat, but even some other, you know, decently priced, good value for money, effective sound deadening materials that you can use as well. Okay, so I just went for a test drive, drove at up to probably about 80-ish kilometers per hour. And I'm actually kind of disappointed. There is a difference, but it's not as distinct as I would have expected. The exhaust noise has definitely gone down a little bit, particularly with the lower frequencies. But one thing that I feel like hasn't really gone down a whole lot is tire noise as you're rolling, and definitely not wind noise. I think that's, I am going to try and tackle that a little bit more, because I do want to make this car as daily drivable as possible. I will be doing more deadening here inside the cabin, so underneath the carpets and all that. I'll do a little bit more in the doors. I've already got sound deadening Dynamat Xtreme that's stuck onto the outer door skins. And I'm also going to do like behind here. I'm going to try and get under the carpet lining that's underneath the rear deck, which is kind of where this roof folds into. I think this roof is responsible for a lot of that. So now this roof, the retractable hardtop roof, is not metal. It's made of some sort of a composite that is most probably to save weight and all of that. One of the main reasons why somebody would choose this over the soft top is for
you know, a more quiet, more comfortable ride. So I really think that Mazda should have, you know, for the additional money that they're investing in this and that they're most probably going to pass on to the customer, for the customer who chooses this over the soft top, they should have put more kind of sound deadening into this, but they didn't. And the sad thing is, because this is a composite and it's kind of all just held in place with adhesive, so like this inner plastic liner, it's all just glued into place with the other materials that are probably layered on with the whole roof unit, or for each roof panel, that is. That I think the rear is a separate panel to this. I'm not really sure how I'm going to tackle this, like without making it look unsightly. First, I'm going to do everything in here, and then I'll see what kind of a difference that makes, whether I'm satisfied with that or not. And if I'm not satisfied, then I'll think about doing something about the roof. Is it worth doing the trunk sound deadening? If you got a really loud, obnoxious exhaust, it might be. I used to have a loud, obnoxious exhaust. It was the, what's their name? Forest Motors in Gunma. You can only buy those in here in Japan. And I'd say it's somewhat similar to the ISR muffler. What I've got right now is the Goodwin Racing race single, the Helmholtz version. I'm not talking about the Helmholtz center pipe or the mid pipe. I've got a standard stock mid pipe. It's just the back box with a Helmholtz resonator chamber attached to it. It's identical to normal race single. It's just got the Helmholtz resonator on it as well. And you can see it if you stick your head underneath the rear bumper. And so that's probably why it didn't seem to make that much of a difference, because the kind of you know, resonating frequencies that you're trying to get rid of with the sound deadening in the trunk, the Helmholtz resonator kind of, you know, does a pretty good job of you know, getting rid of those. If I had a different kind of muffler, I'm guessing I might have seen a more drastic difference. Anyways, thank you for watching, listening to me ramble on and on. If you like what you see, hit the subscribe, hit the like button, drop me a comment, and I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.